Hello, I am Daniel from the Planetarium of Nantes. You can see the arbor. And just behind me, my planetarium.
Well, you organize the IPS website. On the home page, click on the Planetarium Finder here. And on this page, click on the Planetarium Worldwide Database, from the French Association here, WPD. Here is WPD homepage. Faster it is to use engine search, but you can use the map or menu. Of course. If I type, for example, my city name, Nantes, for me, it finds two planetariums. It's normal. There are portable and fixed planetarium. For portable, you have a background, green background. The blue background is for the fixed planetarium. And if you see photo on the WPD, click on photo. Choose by photos, pictures. For example, the first image, the first pictures is a building outside, and click on, you can see the big pictures, some information about this planetarium, of course, and the Google Maps window for the location, the exact location, some information by photos, the team, building, etc., outside. The building. And if I know more about this planetarium at the beginning, in 1981, often you can see just over the Google Maps window a previous installation. If you click on previous installation, you open other page with the same planetarium, the same place, same location, but at the beginning. On this photo, it's the day of inauguration in 1981. I was not here at this time. The same location, of course, and other photo of the construction of the dome, the building. It's funny. And if I can, the first installation with, for example, in my ZKP2 during 25 years, it's a very good machine. Well, but if I want to know more about the very old planetarium for the Centennial of Planetarium, the first planetarium in Germany, very old planetarium, return on the home page and choose the query page here. In the query page, the second line is about the statue. Open planetarium, project planetarium, closed or old. About my planetarium, we talk about the planetarium today. It's open, of course, and the old. Old is the same place, but the building is open today. But for closed planetarium, often the building is destroyed. Choose closed planetarium and choose a country. The country is here. We search about Germany, you know, and just send this question. They list by date, 1923, 24, 26, etc. But there is a bug. If there are some planetarium is outdated, it put this planetarium. So very important. So first in Jena. Click on the photo and you can see on the roof of the factory of Zeiss, on the roof, there are planetarium, the first dome, 16 meters dome, to test the first projector, Mark I. But just one year later, in 1924. In August 1924, the planetarium is open to the public. The first public session were in Jena, on the roof of the factory. Before the Dutch Museum at Munich. Munich, the famous Dutch Museum. The Dutch Museum opened in 1925 officially. But in 1923, there are some tests about the first projector under a small dome. And Oscar Miller from the Dutch Museum wanted two planetarium. A Copernican theater, you can recognize here, very strange, it's not exactly the same planetarium today, but we can recognize a kind of orrery, the solar system. And the next installation, you can see here, the first planetarium with the Zeiss 1 under this dome. And the Zeiss 1 today. It's a very special machine. Well, Munich, Dutch Museum. Return to the list. And the first big planetarium with a 25 meters dome was in Barmen, in this garden. You can see the dome near the palais, the castle, a kind of castle. But today, the Google Maps window, you can see nothing, no building is destroyed. And I found some postal card from this planetarium in Barmen. In Barmen, you can find this plaque, 1926. 1943. Leipzig is a very beautiful building, an octagonal building. This building don't exist today. It's near the zoo of Leipzig. The lobby and just two postal cards. No photos inside the dome. Not yet. Düsseldorf. Düsseldorf is special. It's just a pavilion, a big pavilion for a trade fair in 1926. And this building exists today. You can recognize today is a concert hall. And on this photo, in the middle, you can see Mr. Adler from Chicago, before Adler Planetarium in Chicago, before 1930. Adler visit in Europe, this planetarium. Dresden, big planetarium too, 25 meters. Berlin near the zoo. Today, this building don't exist. But I find only three photos, not inside this planetarium. Jena. On the roof of the factory, Zeiss factory in Jena, there was a planetarium, but the city of Jena built a new planetarium, and this planetarium exists today. it's still a planetarium today. Here, this planetarium at this time. And on this beautiful photo, you can see the Zeiss 2, the Mark 2. It's a very big machine. Almost very heavy, almost 2 tons. The main axis is at 3 meters above the floor. There are 4 wells to push the machine, and different projectors, 2 starboards for the north, for the south, for constellation, for the Milky Way, for different line, equator, meridian, etc. A very, very beautiful machine at this time. It's fantastic. My name. In this garden, there are no building today, but at this time, the Zeiss 2, the Mark 2. Then, Nuremberg, the building exists today. There are no planetarium inside, but this building exists. On this plaque, we have some information, historical information. The building in the next installation is that. Today, this planetarium in Nuremberg from 1961. Well, Hanover, the building exists today. At the top of this building. It's a beautiful dome, a copper dome. And Stuttgart with this beautiful draw. The location of this planetarium in the city. The downtown of the city. Well, it's just some information about the 1st planetarium in Germany before the World War II.
Hello, Alan, Florian, and all the team in Edmonton. We are so sorry, so disappointed, so sad not to be there. But I am sure the crisis will finish. And I hope we can go soon in Edmonton. Bye from all the team of Nantes.